won on Pokemon. Wait, so that last stage was final?
That he lost on.
Oh, that he lost on. Oh, okay. All right. Makes sense. And we got my boy, MkLeo. I don't know if we're ready. He's pointing at us like, ready? I don't know.
We just talking, man.
All right, again, Leo deciding to go Wolf. He's playing Wolf, trying to see if anybody can beat his Wolf. Right now, MkLeo looking to potentially be the best player in the world. He did win Smash Conference. He got fourth at, was it Glitch? Something, yeah, Glitch. But he did win Genesis, the biggest national right now.
Out
so this
2,
kid.
2,000 people. Very talented.
Genius right now. Genius right now. Playing Wolf, seeing if anybody can be able to beat the Wolf. You can't beat the Wolf, you won't get the Ike. You can't beat the Ike, you won't get the Lucina.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the crazy thing about Leo. Like a lot of these other top-level players, they're able to pick up characters really quick. So it's like, oh, flavor of the month? What's up? Why is he so good? All right, cool, let me abuse that. And Leo already making, like, just getting so many good wins with this Wolf.
There's something weird about this game, too, where it feels like it's easier to try to pick up a new character or try out a new character and be good with him after, like, 1 or 2 days. Compared to, let's say, Smash 4, I feel like you had to put in, like, a lot of work. But, like, in this game, you have to understand the game. You have to understand the movement. And if you understand the movement, the game, how to air dodge, etc., you're able to just pick up another character pretty fast. At least a lot of characters.
Right. But just getting to that point can be really hard.
Yes. Getting
these
to that
top
point.
Players, like, they're already, like, essentially, oh, wait, the double dip? Wait. Ah, oh, I wanted to dare. But yeah. Leo going for the back. I respect Leo. Ooh, the parry.
Yeah, Leo, a very safe player. He's not going to go for anything too risky. Like, he's not going to say, hey, let me just go for this. Maybe it'll work out, and I'll get, like, 3 stocks to 1. No, he's going to play safe.
And this is why he's one of the most consistent players. I mean, just so, so talented, and knows that risk-reward is so important in Smash Bros.
Wow, that was beautiful. You saw that F-Smash? Keep in mind, the F-Smash can KO really early, but he did the F-Smash and was able to jab afterwards and not even get punished at all.
Safe on block, especially, or in space correctly, and Leo, definitely the best spacing in the business, so he can definitely do it. Oh, wait. Does
Should
he have
able?
A double jump? Yes, he does.
Should be able to.
Ooh.
Oh, beautiful down smash from Wadi.
Yeah, really good stuff there. Leo didn't sink down to go for the side, but he went for the safer, like, upbeat snap, and Wadi was kind of ready for that.
Holy moly. Did you see that down smash? It looked like he might have charged it. It took a while to get it to come out, but he got that neutral air. He was looking for that down smash. Missed it, but it doesn't matter. 112% go for that F smash, because Wadi could barely be able to punish with this character.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Oh, Wadi not going to follow up on that neutral air. Very big deal here. Rob, definitely one of the better neutral airs of the game.
All right, let's see what Wadi's going to go for. 50% right now. You shooting a lot of projectiles? I remember Wolf does have that reflector. However, he's not using it too much right now.
Yeah, I mean, Leo just in general, even though he does have the blaster available to him, he'll shoot it a couple times, but Leo is very pressure-orientated. Yeah. He wants to get up in your business and really pressure you into making, like, horrible choices. And the thing about it, he plays so fast-paced, and during all these things that's going on so fast, he's still perfectly spacing everything. Yeah. It's actually insane.
That is true. He is an amazing spacer, really good at knowing what's going to KO, getting that read. But that back air by Wadi, able to turn it around and actually get the lead this time around. But 142%, we already know these F smashes, these down smashes, these up smashes have barely any lag. So you can just go for it, and even if it misses, very unlikely he'll get punished.
Oh yeah, and Wolf, pretty much over half of his moves killing. The back row, definitely one of them. What the?
That was really good. That reminds me of Mario, back in the Mario days.
Oh yeah,
Anti would
back.
Always like yeah. roll behind and try to get that back row. Very similar for Wolf.
Oh yeah, and hey, spacey with a kill throw, very interesting concept.
He can go for that bear to down air.
Yeah, I mean, he can kill very, very solid. Even if he doesn't kill right off the bat, he has an option of like going for a double dip or just keeping the offstage pressure going on.
All right, that jab attack looking pretty good to keep them off the stage. 48% right now on Wadi, though. So Wadi already is likely going to look for that up smash if he can get it with the gyro combo. And
is this going to be the first game Leo throws with Wolf? Tries to get the read. Wadi does not hit the forward air on that air dodge to the platform there. Well, wait a minute, but if you give Leo one hit, he can take it all the way. You gotta be careful.
I like that, how he second jumped back onto the stage and did the down air out. Because you know Wadi likes to go for that up air. What is going on?
Yeah, Wadi utilizing that back air from Rob, it actually like pushes him forward as well. Let me see Rob do that. And right now, I think Leo wants to kill right now. There is the up throw, but not enough. The snipe almost gets it. Wait a minute, Leo trying to get back to center stage here, and Wolf with that air mobility gonna find his way there.
Ooh,
man, you gotta be careful.
Green. Good space for Wadi, that gyro, the laser, can he recover? The gyro's still there, neutral air, one more?
No. Man, Leo bringing this all the way back, Wadi at 102%. You gotta be careful, Wolf with this max rage can definitely take out Rob.
Up throw, Kamehameha! Yeah. And that's gonna be a stop.
The pile driver, Leo, finally losing a game with the Wolves. Wow, Wadi able to finally do it.
All right, good stuff to Wadi able to take that first game. I'm wondering, because like you know how you said Leo's going to stay, or they said Leo's going to stay Wolf until somebody's able to take it out. That's one game, and Leo.
I wonder if he meant the set. We'll
yeah,
see.
Because Leo's the type of guy that will switch at the flick of a dime.
Yeah.
And it looks like he decides to stay Wolf. I don't blame him for it. We got Wadi saying, Rob, keep in mind, Wadi was able to take out Void's Wolf, too. So who knows? Maybe Wadi's a Wolf Slayer, all right? He goes out into the mountains.
Yeah, it's pretty nuts, too. I feel like Wadi was a little bit more conservative against Leo's Wolf. In terms of offstage, we didn't see any crazy gimps.
Yeah, he definitely didn't go off stage too much. I know it could be scary, especially because he has two different ways to recover. And that side B, it can be able to spike, right?
Yes.
So you don't want to go.
You want to mess it up and just be like, oh, I'm dead.
I've seen that actually happen, too, in tournaments. So
that's actually like the most tragic. That's like straight tragedy.
Gosh, what's going on?
Wow, and all the way to the edge at 73%. Rob definitely being one of those heavier characters.
Goodness
there
gracious.
And falling fair into the back air. Going to take out Wadi so early.
All right, but Wadi could do the same thing. Check this out. 64% Nintendo. Okay. Okay.
Down throw dash attack in there. Not going to cover that tech.
Wow, this character is crazy, man.
Yes, Wolf is, yo, man, you know what feels the best? Before, like a week before Genesis, I was on Twitter. I was like, dude, this character's insane. This character's insane. And then, like, I was right. Yeah.
He definitely is insane. He got top eight. You see a lot of top players playing him. I know Zero's trying to pick him up. We got Leo playing him kind of for fun, but at the same time, I don't know, maybe he might
pick him up. Pocket Wolf to come through, dog.
They're like, I want to be the new Zachary, man.
One of the best projectile characters in the game. Wolf. Let's get it.
And, okay, beautiful gyro, however, reflected coming out from Leo, but that up air should be able to KO. Let's see if Wadi can bring it back.
Yeah, I mean, 77%, I almost feel like you start the game off at like 60 or 70% as Rob against Wolf, because point conversion can kind of do that much, so.
Actually, Wadi won the first game? Or Leo? It was Leo?
No, Wadi won game one.
Okay, all right. But they'll fix in like 2 seconds. Boom! Yeah, yeah. Okay,
Oh, wait. Oh, my gosh. Maybe he wanted up air. I'm not too sure.
Yeah, if he had charged that up smash a little bit longer, it would have been better, but maybe went for the up air. And unfortunate for Wadi. That could have been a KO. He's in that side B near the top platform.
That here is going to confirm there for Leo. Into that stock, and wow, Leo up a stock. Can Wadi take him out? The up beat to the ledge. I like the mix-up coming out from Leo. And we've seen a lot of up beat mix-ups coming out from Zachary.
One thing I noticed, though, is that Wadi, he likes to go for the projectiles to be able to get that edge guard, because if he knows he gets one little hit, one gyro, one laser, he will be able to stop Leo from being able to recover, because a lot of times Leo has to use that second jump to start the recovery, and a Kamehameha, oh no, no, he's not going to do it just yet.
Yeah, he's not going to do the down throw there. Wadi just opting to throw him off stage. There's the gyro hit, the gyro snipe. Wow, the platform coming in to save Leo.
And Leo, a lot of times, using that second jump to be able to recover high, but Wadi's always looking for Leo to recover low, and that's where he shoots his gyro and lasers.
Man, and can Wadi survive right now? I mean, one thing's for sure is Leo can. At 175, Wadi is not able to find the stock. If he gets a grab, he gets the up throw, but Leo's just not giving it to him.
Yeah, I actually noticed that. Right? He's been going like really high in percent right now. And, okay, up air.
All out.
One more?
Yeah, another up air should do it that high up in the air for sure.
All right, random down smash. I feel like we're looking for that down smash. Oh my gosh. That is a multi-hit, though, but that neutral hit wasn't able to KO. What is a Rob? Look at that. Oh, damn it. It's going to be it.
So now one stock apiece, but Wadi is leading right now, 133%. Leo just simply has to hit one of his smash attacks, but back air even will take the stock out. Can Wadi chip this damage into his favor?
Okay,
wait a minute.
Oh my gosh, what's a Rob?
Oh, I like the beer version as well. And these gyros are doing such good stick damage right now. The dash attack should close it out here against Wadi. So now the set is 1-1.
I actually forgot that Wadi was on his. Okay, yeah, it's 1-1. Okay, we're just updating, you know, making sure they know.
Yes, Wadi did win game one, so now the set is 1-1.
All right, here we go. So it's 1-1. Wolf versus Rob. This is going to happen. We're going to Battlefield.
Yeah,
I think MkLeo is going to stay the same character. He did lose a game while he was playing Wolf and decided to stay Wolf anyway. So let me see the Wolf still come out. And of course, Wadi, I know he's looking for some secondaries. I believe he said after Genesis that he's not sure if solo Rob can do it. Remember, guys, this is early on in Ultimate. So everybody's questioning their life, man. Like, if they go 0-2, then, you know, instead of wondering if they should drop stick, they're wondering if they should drop the game. But no, guys, keep going for it. Keep playing your character a little bit more. It's early on, man. Learn some magic.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, It's with a character or with a roster of 70 plus, 80 plus, like, there's gonna be a lot of matchups you're gonna have to learn.
Exactly, you gotta learn so much. So be sure to practice, guys, and watch a lot of videos like this. You get to figure out what they're doing, man.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, just imitating top players, or at least like seeing how they like to utilize certain tools, and you can apply it in your own way and your own style, which is really like, the coolest part about Smash, in my opinion. Because there's so many different styles that can work in Wadi. Wow, what a call out with the up air. Leo gonna lose the first stock.
He's making Wolf look like one of the lightest characters in the game. I know Wolf is not that heavy. I believe he's the heaviest Spacey.
Yes.
Yes, but like, dying, being KO'd so early, that was off above the top platform with Wadi doing that up air. So this stuff to Wadi on that one, and boom.
Up to a fair, not gonna connect because of the platform, moving attack from Leo, but the chase down, and we see why Wadi has picked this stage. Once he gets Leo on these platforms, the pressure is just really hard for him.
All right, so just in case you guys have to fight Wadi in the future, ban Battlefield,
dog.
Because these platforms, look at that, he just up tilted from the sky, like, what even?
Yep, and the up smash time get punished for Wadi here. Here's the grab into the back, they're just getting him off stage, just to call out.
Oh my gosh, that's a clean F smash coming out from Wadi. Honestly, this is looking like a clean game win for Wadi, especially with these platforms working out so well with the traps.
It's crazy too, because you usually don't see Wadi go for like a lot of these crazy hard reads or like just going combo-wise, but right now I feel like he's really feeling himself and he's just really comfortable on the stage.
Oh my goodness. Just picks it up, turns around, picks it up, turns around, throws it at you. That up smash gonna miss. Leo going for a lot of these KO options and missing it. And I like Wadi playing over. Oh, he tried to get a three stock. He wanna say, and this is the story of how I three stocked Leo. No.
Okay, the down throw. Can Leo even take this first stock? This is looking so rough. Wadi sitting at 1-0, and there it is. Wolf dash attack is also a kill move too. Having a killing dash attack is so nice.
Yeah, it looks so awesome to see. And that was really high percent, so I don't blame it for killing, but right now 89% on Wolf. And Wolf trying to do his combo. What was that? Neutral air? Come on, dude. It looks like he hit under the stage. I know Rob's a really huge character, but come on.
Dude, I'm telling you, man. It's a sword move. that move is legit, like, so disjointed.
Yeah. Now, Rob has to be very careful. One of the biggest characters in the game, but that down air, that F smash charge, or even a down smash with no DI could be able to get the KO. But it looks like Wadi's already looking for that KO, and there it is.
Wow, and yeah, that move is so, so strong. Has so much startup, but covers so much area. So, so powerful. And again, I feel like Wadi just got those hard reads that, like, he was feeling really confident, especially on Battlefield. He just got those hard reads and was able to, like, I wouldn't say obliterating at three stocks, but a very solid two stock coming out.
Yeah, that was a very solid two stock. So good stuff out there coming out from our boy Wadi. Wadi looking really strong. I don't know how I feel about Leo deciding to stay Wolf right now. Again, Wadi was able to take out Boy's Wolf.
Yeah.
Able to take out Leo's Wolf at least 2-1 so far. And that was a clean win. It was also because of Battlefield. So maybe if we get a stage change, it'll be okay. And then maybe if Battlefield isn't picked next, it'll be fine. We'll see about that, though. Let's see what stage we have coming up this summer.
Got Pokemon Stadium, and I love the music, man. It's so good.
Hey, Leo switching it up. Remember, Leo is really good at looking like he's done and then bringing it back. He's like, oh, wait, y'all thought I wasn't the best player in the world? Here, let me remind you.
How fast I can adapt.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of reminded me of Leffen. He's like, the ultimate version of Leffen. Well, Leffen plays ultimate, so he's like Leffen
2. That was a nasty read coming out from MkLeo, and we saw him going for these downers this entire tournament. He finally gets one, nails such a crazy read.
Oh my gosh!
Wait a minute.
Ooh. Yo, Wadi tries to go for Twitter combos, man.
Yo, Wadi about those Twitter combos.
Yo, about those Twitter combos. He needs to post them on Twitter, man. He could have twice as many followers. If he gets that to confirm, look what I did to MkLeo.
There's right. The grab, and Wadi keeping the pressure up. There's no double jump on Leo. Wait a minute. Oh, the down smash a little too late onto the party there.
It looked like he didn't believe. He thought that upbeat might hit him, so he decided to shield, and it didn't actually do anything. Dude, he would have been able to charge the F smash like he did in an earlier match.
And dropping shield does take longer in this game, and Leo finally getting punished for that wolf fight. He's been kind of going for those jump reads all tournament, and now Wadi being the first one to like actually hard punish him for it.
And, okay, dash attack, down tilt. Oh, looking clean. However, this is still looking like Leo's game, especially because you could get a random up smash to work out. And that's an attack I've been seeing Leo go for because, again, it's hard to punish. So you just go for the up smash, it doesn't work. Okay, cool. You probably can't do anything about it. So, no. And he does the same with the F smash, too.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, there's a tech chase. Gets the down smash, but not the sweet spot. Wadi going to survive here. There's a parry on the top. Wadi, again, utilizing that back there to get him closer to the stage.
All right, and Wadi resetting the stage. I like that. Trying to throw out gyro just to be able to get some stage control. But it looks like Leo has a gyro. Down throw, back air. Looking for the up smash. An up tilt, actually. So many KO options coming out from Wolf.
And a very clean parry from MkLeo as well. But can Wadi take out the second stock? He's got the pressure situation, but Leo able to reset to the center stage. Throwing out the blasters, throwing it down a little bit.
One thing I will say also that Wolf is like a really fun top tier. Oh wait, I should have let people know that he's top tier. But Wolf is a very fun top tier to watch in tournament too. So like people aren't gonna complain, oh no, look at Wolf looking cool saying.
Yeah, he's flashy, it's really cool. And like he's a cool, like the concept of the character is really cool. Like the animations on his moves are really cool. I love the claw marks, it's so brutal, it's so savage.
Dude, I'm about to become a furry after watching all this Wolf, man. I honestly he looked cool as heck. If Wolf wanna come over, I'd be like, hold on, I'm kinda scared, but you know, he could come through because he just won his tournament.
Hey,
after seeing his action.
Alright, I mean, you know, you gonna be a Wolf main now?
Nah, I don't
Yeah,
I don't
you
like
don't wanna play him like that though.
We'll see.
You have him come over, but you don't wanna play him like that though.
I've been to the fur combo. Here we go. Nice. I love the way Leo's using gyro to keep that stage control. And Leo right now, 185%, even though it's really bad for him, at the same time, he has a lot of rage. So all he needs is one up air?
Oh, yeah. He needs one smash attack, one like practical like back air up air. Definitely going to do the trick. He's got the rage to do it. And right now, Wadi doesn't really even have confirms either.
And up air. Ooh, almost gets the up air. That was clean.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, that downer made it so it stops the momentum of Rob. So Leo thought, okay, no matter what, he's going to end up right in the spot unless he air dodges. And that downer stopped the momentum. Let's see if Wadi's able to bring it back, but nah.
The foot gonna seal it out. And having that dash attack as a kill option to just get up right in your opponent's face and be like, if I hit this move, you're dead.
Yeah. And good stuff too. Our boy Leo for being able to take that. However, this is game number 5. You saw what happened last time when Wadi had a counterfeit stage choice. He destroyed that Wolf.
And so, there is no DSR in this rule set. So
really?
I wonder, but you get to reban though. There's 2 bans, 7 stages, no DSR.
Oh,
so
okay.
Leo could definitely ban Battlefield now that he knows he's lost on it.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, so he's able to reban. I feel like there's a high chance he'll ban Battlefield unless he feels really comfortable there. Maybe with another character, like, for example, Ike, because he can do neutral air, land on one of the platforms on the side, neutral air, land on the top platform, neutral air, into imagination.
Dang, I just thought about it. I think Leo is low-key trying to get Wolf nerfed.
Yo, stop that, man. Stop that, man. You saw the Smash Ultimate Invitational? This guy literally obliterated Wolf. Obliterated Zero. Leo obliterated Zero with Bayo, and then he switched. And then he switched. He just wanted one match of obliteration and was like, nerf the character. After that, it's anything can happen.
Did I just reveal Leo's like plan? I'm pretty sure he talked to you about this. You know this.
I don't know, man.
You know this.
I don't know what's going
you
on.
You actually know this.
No entiendo.
Wait a minute.
Here we go. All right, now 61% already on Wadi. The ledge trapping is ridiculous coming out from Wolf, as you spoke about.
Oh my God! Zero to death. This character is insane. Wolf, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, Sakura, are you watching? You ready to nerf?
But I gotta say, that was a very clean parry. And I mean, Leo definitely being one of the top players. I feel like the meta's gonna turn to like, hey, you don't parry, like, you're not gonna have a good time.
Yeah, especially versus a lot of characters like Ike, for example, you need to be able to parry. Light seems to be the best player at parrying Ike, and that's why you will not see Leo go Ike against him. But here we go.
Back throw. This character's with like startup on a neutral air, especially like even Rob too. You've seen Wadi come down with these neutral airs, and Leo is ready with the parry because there is startup, and you see that. And amazing DI from Leo, maybe just a display of just how heavy Wolf is, but just gonna survive that up air.
However, there's a lot of rage right now on Wadi, so if he gets an up throw at this percent, should work, but a forward air is simply able to work, especially after that second jump is used.
Yeah, just gonna slap him right off stage here, but the Nair connecting, no follow up though. Ooh, Wadi almost gets the reset, he gets the air dodge, but he doesn't react correctly.
Loki, I think Rob has some of the coolest combos in the game. Like the way he uses gyro, up tilt, forward air, down tilt. Like, he has so many cool combos, but people see him as a big old robot. They see him as a Google Now 3.0, and they're like, you know what? I don't respect it.
Yeah, it's crazy because You know, Rob was definitely not a combo character in Smash 4, but in this game, he's like legit a combo character.
Yes, he's absolutely beautiful. And the way he uses gyro and his projectile, so many setups. It's kind of like Snake, but he can actually move.
Yeah, it's absolutely insane. Wow, Wadi dipped out of there. He like started to side. He's like, wait, I don't want to go.
He's actually lucky that he was able to not get KO'd from that. Especially with the KO power that Wolf does have, he was barely able to win. Uh-oh, going off stage? No. Leo loves to do that, though. He likes to jump off the stage like, oh, I'm going to edge guard just like all the time.
And that back air is so trusty, so deep for Leo. Wadi with the cross-up on the side B. Wow.
That was a very beautiful side B. Did not even punish for it. But back throw, laser, gyro,
short hop gyro.
That's what I'm talking about. Wadi actually using the second jump, and now it's looking even.
Tonight, Wadi coming out, and the projectile master really showing his strength and why he's so efficient with the projectiles. Uh-oh. Oh, wait a minute.
Okay.
The damage and the blaster as well. And the blaster actually was a big deal because it kept Wadi off stage. Leo setting up for this ledge trap. They're not going
to
connect.
I actually thought that Leo was going to jump off stage inside B. However, again, Leo likes to play it safe. It's not going to go too crazy. 91%, however.
Just
one down smash.
Wait a minute. The trip. Ooh, the nair pressure.
Okay.
Leo trying to get that. Oh, a high side B. Ooh, the trade going to save Leo in that situation, though.
All right, he has to be it. Watch out how he's going to recover.
Wait a minute. Oh, the down smash is coming out. The roll behind
up
gets
smash,
covered by Wadi.
Up smash, there it is, coming out from Wadi. One more.
Keitaro got the reach, man.
Oh, man, this is pretty obvious. But that down smash, gonna throw out the gyro. And let's see if you can get that F tilt through the ledge, especially with that gyro there.
Yeah, Wadi utilizing that. Oh, and the kicks, the dash attack will seal it out. Game 5, MkLeo going to take.